Namaste.
Namaste, everybody.
Welcome to day two of our time together with this mantra meditation challenge. For us, it's beautiful to be tuned in every day in this way because it makes us feel connected and it makes us feel like we are all these different light points across the planet, and we take in 15 minutes out of our day to go inside and nourish that inner space that we often forget. And 15 minutes is not much, but it's actually so powerful and potent when we devote ourselves to ourselves for that time. You know, it's a timeless space, so you can't count it in minutes. And it influences the whole day, you know. It affects the whole day, and it brings a quietness and a sacredness into the whole day.
Yeah. You know, the way I've come to understand the mantras is that they're soul food. They feel like soul food to me now. And I just see how easy it is to, you know, feed the body, but to forget to feed the soul. By feeding these mantras into ourselves, we're actually giving ourselves a second chance every time we do this. So that's the gift that I found from the mantras.
And in these days together, we will have some mantras that we will chant together. There's going to be some times when we'll just be listening to a mantra, maybe because it's got too many words to feel comfortable chanting it immediately. And also to feel the difference, you know, what does it do to me when I listen? How does it feel when I actually chant? How does it feel when I chant out loud? And then how does it feel when I keep that mantra with me all day? That's what I would like to encourage you to do each day when we introduce a new mantra. Let's carry that throughout the day. And whenever we remember, let's come back to that mantra. Let it be the last thing that we think of before we fall asleep. So we really dedicate and devote every day to a certain mantra, a certain particular focus that the mantra has. Today we'd like to share with you a very, very simple one. Yesterday we were chanting the sound Om, and today we'll add one more word, which is Shanti, which means peace. So the mantra today is Om Shanti. We like to chant this in the traditional form where we focus on the chanting and the repetitions. So that's really like tuning our instrument, you know. We repeat the sound and we repeat it and repeat it so that it forms and affects our energy system, our bodies. It's like plucking on a string, and then the string gets more and more vibrant. And the same way with our bodies, you know, the more we chant one particular sound vibration, the more we tune ourselves to that vibration. The auspicious number of 108 is because we have these energy lines in the body. According to the Vedas, that we have 72,000 energy lines in the body that are called nadis. And of these 72,000, there are 108 main nadis, main energy lines that all meet in the sacred heart. When we chant one mantra 108 times, then we fill all these energy lines out with that sound vibration. So it's a very auspicious number, and it has many implications, has many reasons. Also, for example, the rosary has 54 beads, so there it comes again. It's, you know, half of a mala. So you can find it in many religions, in many different sacred contexts. You can find this auspicious number. That's why we focus on the 108. So we'll do the counting, and you can just relax, get on the train with us, and let yourself be carried by our voices, and today also with the guitar. And just enjoy and close your eyes and feel.
Just take a moment right now, feel. Let's close our eyes and just contemplate for a while. What does peace mean to you? What do you carry into this? What intention do you carry into this mantra? What are you willing to give it? That's always a good place to approach these mantras. How much are you willing to give the mantra? Because the more you give, of course, like in anything, the more we receive, the more we're open to receive. So take a moment. We just sit in silence for a moment. Close your eyes and contemplate. What is peace?
There's no need to open the eyes. We can just put our awareness to our body position and just get into a very present position, maybe with our back straight, comfortable but with intent and with energy, with presence. And from this space, we can embark on our journey with the mantra Om Shanti Om. It's Om Shanti Om.
Om Shanti Om, Om Shanti Om, Om Om Shanti Om. 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 Shanti Om. Om Shanti Om. Om Shanti Om. Om Shanti Om.
A good moment to remain with our eyes closed and just to enjoy the energy in the body that's been building up with a mantra.
Take a deep breath into this space that we're feeling, that we're all connected in. Born into a world of polarity and into a world of day and night, right and wrong, black and white, this and that. It's just the nature of things, and our journey is not to look for peace outside. If peace comes, we thank God. But we're concerned with our inner peace. We can discover our own inner sanctum, in a world of peace and harmony and loving ourselves as we are. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Have a beautiful day, evening or night. All blessings to you. Namaste.
Namaste.